think about the goodness of Jesus.
Yes.
And I'll be thankful of it. I'll be my soul and pick up of God.
Father, I know you are able to do exceedingly abundantly above all.
faith right now. I speak right now life. I speak right now strength. I speak right now your perfect will. Father, move as only you can, Lord. Oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, I need you right now, God. Oh yes, Lord, I need you right now. Oh yes, Lord. Only what you have to do, God. I thank you right now, God. I thank you right now. Oh, yes, Lord. There's somebody else who's been going through a hard time this week. It's been a struggle, but that's why you have to worship him. That's why you have to worship him. That's why you have to worship him. It's struggle. It's a struggle. I know it hurts. I know you're in pain. I know what you're going through. I understand that you're tired. I understand that you want to give up. But if you lift up your hands today and just talk to the King today and say, Lord, touch me right now, Father. From the crown of my head, Lord, to the sole of my feet. Lord, give me the strength that I need. Give me the wisdom that I need. Father, I need you right now. Somebody to cry out for. From the depths of the heart of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Hey, worship God. Just take us a little bit farther. Just take us just a little bit higher. Enjoy the presence of the Most High God. Let's enjoy the presence of the Holy One of Israel. Let's enjoy what God has for us. Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
thank you.
You know, that it's a necessity in our life. Some may not even have. So God laid upon my heart one of my spiritual mentors, Bishop Dow, once in Atlanta, on yesterday had a fan drive delivery for a senior citizen in the Atlanta area who may not have, you know, just the means. This, you know, it may not be much, but it's a sign that someone cares.
Amen. I said,
my spiritual daddy can do it in Atlanta. I said, I can do it in the country. Amen. And on Saturday, we're going to have a community cleanup, but we're going to change that. We're going to have school in our Saints fan drive giveaway.
Amen.
So we're going to let senior citizens right here in our community, even in surrounding areas, who can come and they can get something that says, you know what, this is not a church that's trying to bring life from the community, but this is a ministry that's trying to give life back to the community. this shall all men know that you are my disciples, that you have love one for another. Amen. That's what we're all about. At the end of the day, we want to operate and we want to be living life on a place of love. A place of love. If you have your Bibles, as I've been doing, I've just been trying to expound some truth with God as it relates to giving. I'm not going to leave off, but I want to get up. I'm here on time today. Amen. I'm trying to leave you. Amen. I started preaching at 12:22 and started off the call at 12:31 last week. Amen. It don't have to be long, but be strong. Amen. 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 I'm going to try to get you out of here. I want you to just look at this because I want to encourage you as you're going to this place of giving. That for some of us, it's uncommitted territory.
Amen.
And for some of us, we try to go because we got hooked up with crime artists, we got hooked up with schemers, we got hooked up with people that were more concerned with God and the Savior than actually helping the people of God. That we need to be retaught and retrained. That we can have a relationship with God, we can trust one another.
Amen.
You know, you guard the rights outside, you saw our being outside, we can put on the new, you start putting on the new roof of the church, amen. Not because I wanted to spend that money, that's why we needed to spend that money.
Amen.
Because a few weeks ago, we came here, we almost had to part the Red Sea.
Amen.
You know, we had money everywhere. And I don't believe the house of God ought to be in shambles. I do not believe the house of God ought to be in shambles. If you ain't going to be leaked on at your house, you are not to be leaked on here at that house. And that causes us to take on the responsibility that where we are. But God wants to bring us somewhere else. 2 Corinthians, the 9th chapter, look at verse number 6. Down to verse number 8, I'm going to speak this, I'm going to say a couple things, and we're going to get out of here with us blessed and offering on today. If we have it, I've got it. Take close attention. He says, but this I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly. And he which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Look at verse number 7. Every man, according as he purposes in his heart, so let him give. Look what he says, because it's not just the act of giving, it's the spirit that's enabling him to give. He says, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth and cheerfully. I cannot wait that this is a church that's happy every time you meet. Have you ever noticed in church that you'll be having a good time while moving their hands out of the bus office and you say, oh, man, everybody saw this right there?
Amen.
Your marriage,
No lack.
Praise the Lord.
Your relationship with your children?
No lack.
No lack. Your job?
No lack.
No lack.
Mm-hmm.
Your mind?
Hey,
no lack.
Lord.
Your emotion?
Yes, Lord.
No lack. And your mind?
No lack.
No lack. She said, I am able to make this grace.
Yes.
Abound towards you.
Amen.
That you will have all sufficiency.
Oh.
In all things. If you're thinking about money, you're at the kindergarten
now. Amen. Amen.
You're all right. Amen.
All right. Amen. I'm trying to get you out of kindergarten.
That's right.
Amen.
But I'm talking about when you're able to go home.
Amen.
And you have the peace that you deserve.
Ooh. Thank you. Thank you.
Amen.
From a cheerful place.
From a happy place.
From a loving place.
I give now
unto you
and your work.
And because
I give to you,
I believe
now.
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 I have
all sufficiency.
In all things.
No more lack.
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 In my life.
In my life.
In Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
If you're tithing with us on today, I want you to stand right now with your tithes in your right hand, that you will lift it up in the presence of the Most High God. I just believe you ought to jump up and lift up, 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 jump up and lift up. If you have a time, if you have a offering on today. I want you to get your offering in your right hand. And I want you to lift this up. I want you to wave it right now. Just like you don't care. Because you don't care about letting this go, because you know when God is about to bring that to you. It may leave your hand, but it will never leave your life.
Thank you.
Matthew chapter number 25. Matthew chapter number 25. We're going to begin from line verse number 35 down to verse 4. Matthew 24, chapter 33, verse. Amen. I don't have my vertical heart in the way. Amen. 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 Amen.
Even in the church age that has made us masters in mediocrity.
But we're not even vibrating weak theology. We got to become masters and get concerned with what we want and what we need and what we have to have. That somewhere along the way we have forgotten the necessity of being brothers or sisters.
Oh, yeah.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
We're living in a day and time where people, as long as their house is okay, as long as their family is all right, as long as they do not have any trouble knocking at their door, that they are not concerned with anybody else. Yes, it is a very sad day in which we live because many people are just so focused just on me. It's me this and me that. It's I want this and I want that. It's that as long as I can get what's for me, I am not worried about anyone else. It's very dangerous because it goes against everything that gospel is all about. It's very dangerous to have this kind of mind frame in the context of the gospel because the gospel is always about helping people who cannot even help themselves.
Amen.
Okay, she said, this is good about pastor. If I was them, I'm not going to help nobody that won't help themselves. They ought to be doing something for themselves. I think God, that he is not like us. Because when I could not help myself, when I could not get myself out of the mess I got myself in. Oh, I wish I had a church out here. If I had a God that said, "Poor deal, I would not let my son die because you didn't try to die for yourself." I thank God that I have a God that looks beyond every one of my shortcomings. And let me tell you, they are many. I got a lot of sometimes I'm grouching, sometimes I'm going crazy, sometimes I say stuff I shouldn't say, sometimes I don't do stuff I need to do, but I thank God that he said, "Barfield, even though you got a lot of mess up in your life, I still got enough to come down out of glory, step over eternity right in the fire, and I will die on the cross with you, because I know you can't help yourself." I thank God today, that I can stay today, that I can stay before you today, knowing that I'm crazy and sometimes they think I'm bipolar. I wish I could tell you, I thank God today that I can stand before you opening up this book of life and preach a gospel to you that sometimes I do not feel qualified to preach. Because I realize sometimes, even in the greatest of efforts, in the greatest of lifestyles, that you try to do things and yet you fall flat, you don't do enough, and you try to do more, and it seems like the good that you want to do, you don't do, but the evil you don't want to do, you end up doing. I don't know if you feel like that. Sometimes I try to bless people, and when I try to bless them, I hurt them more trying to bless them than if I would have just left them alone. Sometimes I try to do good, but evil. Living, come on, you to get sour, man. Yeah. Because you're just so bitter. Yeah.
room today.
Yes.
Through that I've had trouble,
yes.
I've had pain,
yes.
I've had
pressure,
yes. I've had fallen short of the
Lord.
He has one, but not twice. You were coming late, were clocking in late, leaving early, but
sometimes never receives any credit.
Come on.
For the good.
Yes, right.
But they always say, why me, Lord?
Yes.
For the bad.
Yes, right.
Oh, he said, I'm the one.
I'm the one.
When things are going good.
Yes.
They don't ever want to talk about me.
Yes.
They don't ever want to mention me.
No, yes.
But what happens as soon as things are going to
come on.
As soon as the money starts drying up.
Yes.
Why is this that I go over here and you bless this person? I pray for them, but and you raise them up. But I pray for my grandparents, and you let them transition to the other side. Why, God, do you use me to bless this person? understand that you're righteous, you should have known what your righteousness was. But if you find out that your righteousness is not based upon you anyway, it's always based upon God, you'll realize you can't live holy enough to bad, you can't live bad enough to lose.
Hey. Jesus of that pastor.
Amen.
Yeah.
Whatever you do to all of them over there.
Yes.
He says you do it. If I go back to about the 1989, I think Janet Jackson had a song that Jesus might vote for. What happened? I know what you've been doing for others. For what have you done?
Thank you.
my good friend, about to come and sing a song. And the boys are going to be praying. You're sitting there. I mean, you're going to come. You're about to come later. Amen.
realize.
Yes.
Don't get mad at the test of this.
Yes.
But he could be serving life in prison.
Woo!
For some craziness that he did in his youth.
Yes.
Ain't that right? There's a story behind the praise. There's a story behind the worship. There was no wicked or what he was wicked at. But he had 5 years touched him and 5 years used him.
Yeah. Yeah.